Happy Wednesday or Tuesday. Your assignment is to take some notes on volcanoes. You can do this on Tuesday or Wednesday, or do half of it on Tuesday and half of it on Wednesday. You will need to open up your assignment for today, and you are taking notes in the notes and looking at the slideshow. You're not writing on the slideshow. You don't need the slideshow to be shared. You're just writing here on your notes. There was a typo on number 6. You don't need to answer it. If you prefer to take notes on paper, you can take notes on paper instead. Just show me what you did, and I'll make sure you get credit if you don't want to do it online. Today, we're continuing talking a little bit about volcanoes. The answers to the notes are in the slides, and this is also shared. Otherwise, it should be pretty easy to fill them in as you watch this video. We've been talking all about volcanoes, so let's stop and define them. A volcano is a cone-shaped mountain or hill, which usually has a crater or depression, like a little hole in the top. They can erupt all the time, or sometimes they just erupt randomly. Sometimes they erupt at a regular cycle, so every 10 years or every 100 years. Not every hill or mountain is a volcano, but some hills are when they have a magma chamber underneath them. We're going to talk about 4 distinct types, but there are many other different types and also things that are similar to volcanoes like geysers, which aren't quite the same thing. There are 3 stages of a volcano. They can be active. This is when there's lava and things coming out. Or they can be dormant, which is where they're just waiting. They're kind of like they're sleeping or loading. And it can go back and forth between being dormant and active quite a lot in its lifetime. But eventually, it can become extinct, and then it's not going to be erupting or dormant ever again. So it can go back and forth between these, but once it's extinct, then it's done. There's no more lava. It's safe to be around. There are many different types of volcanoes, depending on what kind you have. I want you to understand that there is a magma chamber at the bottom, and it's going to come up through a main vent. We can also have some side vents, but we're just focused right now on our main vent and our magma chamber. There are 4 kinds of volcanoes. Composite volcanoes and stratovolcanoes are the same thing. We'll use both cinder cone volcanoes, shield volcanoes, and lava dome volcanoes. A composite volcano is a large, symmetrical, cone-shaped mountain, and it's built with lots of different layers. So every time it erupts, sometimes it'll grow a little bit bigger. But then sometimes when it explodes, some pieces of it will fall off. Mount St. Helens is one example. So it got a little bit smaller when it erupted, but then it also got a little bit bigger at the bottom. Cinder cone volcanoes, they're kind of what we talked about being kind of like cannons. They're going to shoot out blobs of lava. So they're not always as nice of a flow of other eruptions. They are small cone-shaped volcanoes with steep angled sides. You can see them in Mexico or Arizona. I'd love to find out if you've ever been to one. The next time we're talking about is a shield volcano. I want you to think about if you poured some water on your table, it's going to just spread until it makes a big puddle. That's kind of like a shield volcano. It's going to spread and make this big, flat, sort of hill. And that's why it's called a shield. Like it resembles like if you threw Captain America's shield on the ground. The lava dome are the opposite. They're like if you poured, instead of water, if you poured some chocolate or some goo, and it doesn't really spread. It just kind of sits there in a big mound. So the lava's cooling much slower and it's piling up. Volcanoes usually happen where plates are thin or where there's subduction occurring.